a great pleasure for me to be sharing with you the current nutrition situation in Zimbabwe. Food and nutrition security issues are a priority for the government of Zimbabwe, and they occupy a prominent position in the country's economic blueprint of the Zimbabwe agenda for sustainable social economic transformation, which is the CMAS. Honorable members of parliament, members of the press, and distinguished guests, allow me to define nutrition security. Nutrition security is when all people, and when I say all people, it's from in vitro up to the oldest. When all people, at all times, doesn't matter where they are, at all times, consume food to sufficient quantity and quality. Not only quantity, but also the quality in terms of variety, diversity, nutrition, nutrient content, and safety to meet their dietary needs and food preference for an active, healthy life, coupled with a sanitary environment and adequate health services and care. It's a mammoth task of a sort of a definition. Ladies and gentlemen, nutrition goes beyond the food availability. It is the end result of the food consumed, how it benefits God's health. However, it is of concern that foods consumed by most households lack diversity and are largely unbalanced, with a clear dominance of carbohydrates. And sometimes sides and cocoa, so monotonous sometimes, no variety. And they are largely unbalanced, with the clear dominance of carbohydrates over protein. Fruits sometimes are also not eaten in the form at all. Vegetables, depending on how you prepare them, by the end of the day, your plate is brown to green, it's supposed to be, which means you are only left with high fiber. Then besides the high fiber diet, you don't know what next. And this is what is going on in most of our households. The major nutrition challenges in Zimbabwe are chronic malnutrition and micronutrient deficiencies. Nearly 1 in 3 children under the age of 5 years is stunted. And we are talking of stunting here, we are talking where the brain has failed to develop accordingly because it lacks specific micronutrients that are required from in vitro up to the age of 2 years. So within the first 1,000 days, if the child does not get what is adequate and is not properly cared for with other issues around for her, the child gets stunted, might be looked too short for the age. After 5 years, we are only maintaining the child just to grow. Then you'll be Mr. Handsome Fatcher or Miss Beautiful Fatcher. But the way the child operates or the way he or she goes around his daily work is affected, sort of clumsy, and you want to know what's wrong with this child. It's because the brain did not get what it was supposed to get at the critical age of the first 1,000 days. The starting rates have fallen from 35%, which used to be from 2009, to 27.6%, according to 2014 study. However, we are not comfortable still. It's too high, above 20, that's too tall. We need to be below. That is due to the proportion of targeted community already implemented. However, more needs to be done to accelerate stunting reduction in the country to meet the global World Health Assembly targets of 40% reduction by 2025. So by 2025, we should be way below 20%. Ladies and gentlemen, Zimbabwe is also experiencing a double burden of malnutrition with increase in the prevalence of overweight. I'm sure when you're moving around, even the combis, even in the buses, you see men who seem to be pregnant, you see women who need to take 2 seats instead of one, and they are moving around. They change clothes every time, which means obesity is becoming a problem. About 4% of our children at the age of 5 years are overweight. These children are given anything that comes. Too much of it is carbohydrate. Sometimes it's potato, sometimes it's potato soup, which is carbohydrate plus carbohydrate, the child is eating nothing. All it does is just put more fat into your system. Therefore, about 20% of our women of childbearing age are being overweight. And urban areas found to be having more overweight women than in the rural areas. Maybe in the rural areas they're too active, they're too busy, but still we have obesity also in the rural areas. Ladies and gentlemen, Zimbabwe is a breastfeeding nation. I heard my honorable minister is something on India. And the school breastfeeding has been done up to 6 months. And continued up to 24 months is promoted. But however, breastfeeding studies have shown that just below half of our population can exclusively breastfeed their infants up to 6 months. Simply because some cannot, some can. But then we are worried because within that 6 months, that's where we have to address the issue of stunting. Micronutrient deficiency also remains a major public health problem. And according to the latest micronutrient survey, which we did in 2012, nearly 32% of our children under 5 and 26% of our women of childbearing age are anemic. Which means they are not as strong, they lack the energy they're supposed to have, they don't have adequate blood flowing into their system. So they are lethargic most of it. The country is still battling with the high communicable disease prevalence, especially HIV and related illnesses, and that continue to contribute to the aggravated malnutrition in the country. Nearly 20% of acute malnutrition amongst both adults and children is related to these communicable diseases. In view of all this that I said above, it is in view of this mentioned that challenge that the Ministry of Health is facing commits to contribute towards this massive agenda. We are doing certain things to make sure that we reduce stunting. One of the activities we are doing is we are preventing and reduce stunting, especially during the first 1,000 days period, where we are encouraging mothers to exclusively breastfeed up to 6 months and continue up to 2 years with the appropriate diet for the mother and after 6 months, the woman with the appropriate diet and proper complementary feed. The also promotion of recommended optional feeding and young child feeding practices in communities, institutional level, e.g. the baby friend was pre-initiated, the monitoring was a promotion. We are also promoting of health eating and lifestyles to address the increasing burden of non-communicable diseases, minimum consumption of sodium, minimum consumption of alcohol, minimum consumption of fats, and also increase of diversified local foods, particularly on the fruits and vegetables that are fresh and well stored, not those that are rotten one pattern, you cut one pattern, you throw away the other pattern. Then we have the problem of other eggs, of other, those worms, the eggs that enter into us. And we end up also having the problem of some ailments within our systems. Improve child and maternal survival through programs promote micronutrient-rich foods and related diseases. For example, here in Zimbabwe, we are also supplementing our under 5, 6 to 59 months with vitamin A, and our salt in the country is iodized, so whenever you buy your salt, check to make sure it's iodized. And then also we have our women who are pregnant are being supplemented with iodine folate. We also ensure that the foods that are imported and locally produced are evaluated for safety, and also execute effectively our role as the Food and Nutrition Security Committee Secretariat at all levels. Ladies and gentlemen, we also have documents in place. We have a new Food and Nutrition Security Policy. We have that the National Nutrition Strategy which was launched by the VP, and then the dissemination was launched by our Honorable Mandi Chimene, that's a few say boy in Manigala. We also have the food 43 strategy in place, and we have done several studies, short documents to contact the office. In conclusion, as a ministry, we appeal for the concerted approach in addressing nutrition challenges we are currently facing as a country. The ministry is at the receiving end of all issues not adequately addressed by the key stakeholders. Ladies and gentlemen, let me conclude by calling all Zimbabweans to take up the position in making Zimbabwe a free hunger and malnutrition country. Remember, you are what you eat. Your lifestyle tells us a lot as you move around. If they are carrying too much weight or you have too little weight, or we are just someone who looks just like someone, but are we healthy? Thank you very much.